Hi, in this video, we will learn about a new feature called Axis Constraint. This is the toolbar of the Axis Constraint. By default, it's not part of the user interface, so right-click here, empty space on the toolbar, and choose Axis Constraint. Axis Constraint works together with Snap. So Snap should be on to use the axis constraint. If it's off, we cannot use it. It's useless. To activate the axis constraint, you can click on this button, on and off, or you can use the keyboard shortcut Alt D. Now, first, let's try the snap without the axis constraint to learn, to understand why we need it. So I have my snap on, right click and make sure the vertex snap mode, snapping mode is checked. Now I will choose this box. And of course, you need to activate the move tool. I will hover my mouse over this vertex, and let's say I want this vertex to be aligned with this corner here. So I will click here, and I move it and place it over this corner. I will undo. Now, let's say I want this corner to be aligned with this corner, but only on the x-axis. I don't want this corner to jump. I don't want this box to jump on all axes and be placed here. I want this corner to, let's say, steal the x-coordinate of this corner here. But the problem is, as you can see, the three axes, the X, Y, and Z, are three of them are yellow. That means the three of them are activated at the same time. So I am forced to use to move on all directions. So this is where axis constraint comes into play. Activate the axis constraint. I will use the shortcut Alt D. Now, if I want to align this corner with this corner only on the X axis, I should also activate the X constraint. I can use also the keyboard shortcut F5. F6 is for the Y axis. Now I'm using the keyboard shortcuts. F7 is for the Z. F8 is for the X and Y. I can do an axis constraint on two axes at the same time. As you can see now, X and Y are yellow because I activated this one. When I click Z, the Z axis is yellow, as you can see here. If I press the Y is yellow, and the X is yellow. Now, X, Y, now both of them are yellow. If I keep pressing the F8, if I press it another time, now the constraining is happening on the Y and Z axis, as you can see now, Y and Z. And if I press the F8 again, it's ZX. So I will press the F5 now to activate the X axis. Make sure axis constraint is on and the snap is on. When I move my mouse over the this vertex, I will click hold. Then, as you can see, the movement is constrained on the X axis. It doesn't go up and it doesn't go on the Y axis. So I move my mouse over this vertex or this vertex. It's the same, and then I will release the mouse button. Now, as you can see, they are aligned. This corner is aligned with this corner on the x-axis. Now, let's say I want to align the bottom with the top of this box. Now, in this case, I can use two methods. I can hover my mouse over this vertex, click, and now it's still on the x-axis. So while I'm holding the box without releasing the mouse button, I can press the F7. As you can see, now it is it changed to Z, and I can move my mouse here. And now the bottom of this box is aligned with the top of this box. Now I will do Control Z. Now I will switch to X again just to demonstrate something. Now, since the XYZ axis, the move tool is at the bottom. In this case, I don't need to use the shortcut F7 to switch to Z. What I can do, I can just move my mouse over the Z axis. It will flash yellow. When I click on it, it will switch immediately, automatically to Z. And I can move my mouse over this vertex, and it is aligned. So we can do more tests. I will right click the snap, and I can choose the midpoint. The midpoint let me snap on the middle of any edge, like this. So let's say I want the vertex of this box to be aligned with the x-axis of the middle of this edge here. So I can hover my mouse here. I see the X, the vertex snap flashes yellow, this cross like. So I can click. Now it's still on the Z, so I will press F5 to activate the X constraining. Then I move my mouse here. The midpoint snapping is on. It flashes. So I release the mouse button, and as you can see, they are aligned now. The vertex is aligned to the midpoint of this edge. So I think this is enough for now. You can go on and practice yourself to get used to it. It's very useful. To place objects in the scene accurately. And hope you like this video. If you like it, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel. And see you next time.